Hello children, welcome to my English session. Today I have the lesson Padmini the Princess. In the last video we have discussed about the boy who is telling the story and his grandmother Amma and the boy's father and veterinary doctor Manoj uncle and a baby elephant who has got hurt. Amma lives near the edge of the village, very near to the forest, and once she finds an elephant who has got badly hurt. She has got wounds on her trunk, so Amma wanted to help her. So she tells to his son, and his son, that is boy's father, finds a veterinary doctor, that is animal doctor, that is Manoj uncle. He agrees to help the baby elephant who has got badly hurt. So today let's read the lesson and find out what is the story about our baby elephant Padmini the Princess. Padmini the Princess. To my delight, father and Manoj uncle took me along to Amma's house. "Amma, tell me what happened to the elephant," said Manoj uncle. Amma said, "I think she was caught and held in ropes and chains, while the rest of the herd escaped. She was able to free herself with great difficulty. The wounds are giving her a lot of pain. She cannot eat or drink properly, so she is weak. I take her sugarcane and a little water, but she is too frightened to eat or drink. But as soon as the wounds heal, I'm sure she will return to the forest." Amma had named her Padmini. She and Manoj uncle went first to see Padmini. Soon they came back and Manoj uncle told us, "Padmini's trunk is cut in many places. The wounds are deep." Here the boy is telling the story for we people in the lesson. And he is telling he was very much delighted. Means he was so much happy that boy's father, that is his father and Manoj uncle, agrees to take that little boy to Amma's place with them. So he is very happy so that he could see the wounded elephant. So they goes to the Amma's place, and first father and Manoj uncle visits where the elephant was. And they look and examine the elephant and they will come back to the Amma's house. There Manoj uncle asks Amma, "What happened to the elephant, Amma?" "Yes." Then Amma says, "She might have caught and held in ropes and chains." Actually, elephant, they live in groups called herds. All the elephants might have caught in ropes and chains. Ropes and chains means, in Kannada we call Hagga Matte Sarpani. All the other elephants have been escaped because they have grown up. But this elephant was little one or the younger one in the herd. So she could not go, she could not escape with them. And finally she had come out, she had freed herself with that ropes and chains with very much difficulty. And she has also tried to come out of that ropes and chains. During that time she got hurt on her trunk and her legs also. And Amma took little sugar cane and water near the elephant. But even the elephant is frightened to see the human being around it. So the elephant did not drink or eat. And she has become weak. Without eating and drinking, it has become weak. All the things Amma is telling to Manoj uncle. And Amma also says that after the healing up of the wounds, the elephant will return to the forest. See how good Amma is. Then Amma has given her a name also. She used to call her Padmini. It is name of a very beautiful Rajput princess. Padmini annodu Rajput manetanada ondu sundaravada Rajkumariya hesaru. Adana avaru elephant ge itirtare. She used to call her by name Padmini. And Manoj uncle tells Amma that the cuts, the wounds on the elephant's trunk are very deep. He has to clean them and he has to stitch them. Let's continue reading. Then he took out a gun. Amma looked at it and had tears in her eyes. Manoj uncle explained, Amma ji, this won't kill Padmini. I have to stitch her wounds. I can do that only when she is asleep. This gun has bullets that will make Padmini sleep for a few hours. The bullet worked and Padmini was soon asleep. While she slept, Manoj uncle cleaned and stitched her trunk gently. Then he returned to Amma's house, looking tired but happy. The next day, before he left, he told us how to look after Padmini until he came back. After telling all about the wounds of the elephant, Manoj uncle, that is veterinary doctor, takes out a gun from his bag. And Amma started to cry. She thought Manoj uncle is going to kill Padmini. Then Manoj uncle explains, these small guns will have bullets. They won't kill Padmini. They are just like tablets. If that is shot into the body of the elephant will go to sleep. When the baby elephant is sleeping, Manoj uncle can clean the wounds and make a stitch on it. Otherwise, it is impossible. If the elephant is awake, Manoj uncle cannot treat the wounds. It may push him away using his trunk. So, he shot a bullet into the body of the elephant and made Padmini to sleep. Then he cleaned the wounds of the Padmini and stitched it gently. And that night he stayed there only. He could not able to come back to his place. So he stayed in Amma's house only. And while coming back, he gave the instruction to Amma and the boy how to look after the elephant. Got it? Let's continue further. Days later, Amma decided to take me to see Padmini. Amma said, Padmini is much better, but she still needs some help to eat and drink. We walked to the forest and soon came an old temple. Amma rang the lodge bell there. Very soon, a few small animals came to the temple. Then some birds. We must never show animals that we are afraid, said Amma. It makes them feel that we might harm them. She gave some food she had bought with her. Manoj uncle cleans the wounds of the Padmini. He ties the bandages around it. He gives the instructions to look after Padmini and he moves away. Padmini was living near the Amma's place only. After 2 days, the boy and Amma goes to see Padmini, how she has recovered. They want to know. So, goes near a old temple there. And Amma rings the bell over there. As soon as Amma rings the bell, small animals came around her. She gave them food, what she had bought with her. And after few minutes, few birds also came flying. She gave food grains to them also. And Amma is saying, the boy, that we should not show our feeling of afraidness in front of the animals that we are afraid of them. If we show that feeling, they will not come near us and eat what we give. Let's continue the lesson further. Where is Padmini? I asked. Amma just smiled. Soon there was the crunching sound of leaves and branches. It was Padmini with bandages around her trunk. She came up to Amma.
Amma patted Padmini's trunk gently. How are you feeling, my child? She asked softly. She held out 2 bananas. Remember what I told you? She said, don't take off your bandages. Then she said, let's go to the river. You need some water. We all walked to the water's edge. Padmini knelt down. I poured water into her mouth. Many buckets of water. Soon it was time for Padmini to return to the forest for us to go back home. Seeing the forest and Padmini was like a dream. It was magical. So, the boy and her mom, they were near the temple. All the birds and animals came and they started eating the food what Amma has given. But where is Padmini? Then they hear the sound of the crunching noise of the leaves. Because elephant is a very huge animal, no? When it puts its legs on the dried leaves, it make a crunchy sound. Padmini came slowly near to Amma. Amma had bought two bananas to her. And she treats that baby elephant or Padmini as her own child, own grandchild. She pats on her trunk and she says, remember, you should not take out your bandages until it is healed. And she gives two bananas to Padmini. Padmini is also happy. She eats the bananas. Then Amma says, Padmini needs some water. Let's go near the water's edge or near the river. So Padmini, Amma and the boy goes. You can see in the picture, the boy is putting so many buckets of water into Padmini's mouth. Because her trunk is wounded, she could not eat or drink herself. So somebody's help is needed. Amma fed her two bananas. Here the boy is giving her the water. And they were very happy. After few days, the Padmini's trunk has completely healed up. Amma took out all the bandages out and it was time for the elephant to join its herd or the group. She was deep inside the forest to meet her family. The boy and Amma has to come back to their home. The boy was very happy. It was a new experience for him with the elephant. And it was like a magical thing for him. And in these days, in the forest and with Amma, the boy learned how to love and take care of the wild animals. Got it, children? That's all about the lesson. This lesson teaches us how to love and take care of the animals. In this world, there are so many people. They give trouble to wild animals. Like Padmini was caught and held in ropes and chains. Who has made that one? People only. But there are also people who love and care for the wild animals. And second thing is the love of Amma about the wildlife. She treats them all as her own children. She gives them names and she loves them, protect them, feed them as her own children. And also speaks to Padmini as her own child. And the third thing is the relationship between the boy and Amma. Being with Amma all these days, the boy learns how to take care of the wild animals, how to love them and how to protect them. And this story also tells that the knowledge from the old aged people, that is from one generation, without teaching anything, by her good behavior only, she passes the good values to her grandchild. By looking at Amma only, he learns so many things, that is not to harm the wildlife, to protect them and to love and care them. Got it, children? You should not harm any animals. If possible, show kindness towards them, feed them, protect them and love them. If it is not possible for you, don't harm them. Got it, children? That's all about the lesson, Padmini the Princess.